All right, so hey, it's Energyone, and I promised a Q&A video, and you guys sent me some questions, and we're going to go ahead and do this anonymously for now, and if the future you'd like me to go ahead and give a shout-out to whoever, or at least give credit to the person giving the question, that's fine. I thought I'd make it generic since a lot of people might benefit just basically from the answer to the questions, and we'll go ahead and get started. All right, what's the best armor-busting lightning setup? Well, basically, you'd want the AP weapon, and I personally go with Heat, as it's more of a well-rounded weapon, and I do the same with the Mag Rider as well. I typically would rather have the more well-rounded nose cannon, I guess you could call it. Basically, you'd want to go ahead and grab the AP if you are just looking to attack armor. It basically says it right in the description of the weapons itself, so this should be fairly easy to understand. On mine, and that's usually what I'm going to go with as far as giving advice on what I personally use or personally recommend, I go with auto repair on faster vehicles. Basically, I prefer being able to get away and not always have to be an engineer when I'm driving. Speaking of gaming mice, do you have any experience with the Mad Cat Cyborg Rat Mice? I'm looking for a new right-handed wired gaming mouse, mostly for FPS games. Could you tell me your thoughts on the Rat or suggest another mouse for a casual gamer? I actually have a friend who's owned, I believe it was the Rat 7 or the Rat 9, and he liked it actually quite a bit, but this was actually several years ago. The mice are really expensive, so when you mention it for a casual gamer, I basically would probably look at the G500S from Logitech. And I don't mean to favor Logitech, but they do actually make excellent products, at least in my history and experience. And those mice, the Rat mice, are really expensive for what they do. Alright, we got a two-parter here. What weapons do you use as an infiltrator, and what planet do you come from? Well, okay, I play infiltrator a lot. I play all the classes. I probably play light assault the least, and it's not that there's anything wrong with it. In fact, I enjoy it quite a bit, and I really should play it more. It's just that I prefer infiltrator. I played a cloaker a lot in the original planet side as well, and I play spy a lot in Team Fortress 2, for example. I just kind of enjoy that role. Okay, so what weapons do I use? Well, I've used a lot of them, and currently, we'll go with that answer. Currently, I'm using what I stated on FNO, and that's the scout rifles. That's the Artemis and the Nyx. And oh my god, the Nyx is so awesome. I kind of wanted one anyway, and I waited for them to go on sale, which they did during the holidays, and I grabbed one. And basically, Higby had sent out a tweet showing effectiveness of certain weapons versus popularity and so on. And the Nyx was way up there, and oh yeah, I can see why. This thing hits like a tank. The only issue is that it's not very adaptable. You have to kind of do some things like get a laser sight to help you with close quarters combat and really kind of mess around with the different scopes just to find your particular particular comfort zone. Sorry about that. Can't speak today. And that might be because of the second question. What planet do you come from? Well, here's the thing. Now we'll get back to that in a minute. I just want to make sure that the line is clean. So the other things I use is the Hunter cloak. Like most people, I have both cloaks, but prefer Hunter, like the majority. I use proximity mines probably the most. In fact, I got Araxium on just the mines like a few months ago already. But I use that. I'm using Nanoweave right now, but in the past I've used the ammo belt. And I use medkits on the Nyx build I've got, or if I'm sniping long range. I just prefer that, since I'm not going to be anywhere near where I need to put prox mines. So, yeah, that's mostly what I use. I use EMP grenades, and right now I'm using the Cerberus because it's the hardest-hitting pistol that we have access to as Vanu that can also support a suppressor, which is pretty necessary. And on the Nyx, I use a suppressor as well, and the same with the Artemis. But yeah, I'm enjoying all of those. And regarding the planet I come from, I can't tell you, they'll find me. Did you pre-order or back Star Citizen? No, I did not. There are some outfit mates that are interested in the game. I am not ready to plunk down anything for that yet. I'll wait and see how it turns out, and maybe even after release I'll check it out. We'll see how it turns out, okay? What do you think of Smite, the third-person MOBA that's coming out in March? Well, honestly, I really hate the MOBA genre. I'm gonna go ahead and check out Heroes of the Storm, simply because I think that Blizzard might show us something new, and I want to give it a fair chance, but I really dislike the multiplayer online battle arena games, like League of Legends and all that, and Dota and all that stuff. I don't know what it is. I think a lot of it is because I really, really, really hated Warcraft 3. I think it's probably the worst RTS game I've ever played in my life. And I know that a lot of people love that game, but I despised it with a passion. I really liked Command & Conquer Red Alert 2 with the Yuri's Revenge expansion. That's probably one of my top RTS games. StarCraft is in there, of course, StarCraft 2 and all that. Generals was great. I was really upset when they canceled Generals 2. But yeah, a lot of my friends and I would just have a blast. I played China, I remember, with all the nuclear weapons in Generals. But no, I'm not interested in Smite. I've seen footage of it. I know it's a little different because of the perspective. And I'll give it a chance, but I'm really not interested right now. I haven't looked into it because of the genre it's in. And I just dislike it. You know, a lot of people hate sports games, for example, when it comes to video games. And it's kind of like that for me in regards to MOBAs like League of Legends and so on. See, here's the thing, and I want to expand on that. There's nothing wrong with these games, and I don't want to badmouth them at all. It's just people have their preferences, and I have been a gamer for a long time. Those of you who watched FNO, there was a couple of you that had commented that I was a lot older than I sound, and I don't know how to really take that, but basically I've been around for it all. I've been around since Pac-Man. I wasn't around for the stuff before that. Because, you know, well, I mean, I played Pong and all that, but I had never actually played on an arcade Pong unit. I played on some of the home console ones, but yeah, I've been around a long time. I've seen it all. I've done it all. And this industry is still remarkable to me. I still love playing, and I probably always will. And it's kind of interesting because I'm kind of one of those people in that time frame that I get to basically... you know, show the industry how long people will play for, what their changes are like, how jaded I can become, things like that. Like I've said, I've seen everything. I've seen some shenanigans, I guess you could say it, from the game industry. And yeah, I know what I like. I really like FPS. I like a good role-playing game. I love a good MMO. I love the fighting game genre. Yeah, I like a lot of them. I even like the occasional turn-based strategy once in a while, and real-time strategy. But yeah, that's the thing. Don't take what I say about Star Citizen or Smite as something against those games at all. I'm just not ready to look into those particular, since you had asked me directly what I thought about those particular games. Alright, here's a multiple question list I've got from a person. What weapons do you use as a combat medic? Well, I still stick with the mainstays. I go with the HV45 or the TAR if I'm playing TR or so on, even though they got nerfed. I'm using the Cerberus for everything right now just because I want to basically use that gun a lot and get a good feel for it. Otherwise, I prefer the Underboss. Even more so than the Commissioner, even though I've used both, and the Commissioner packs a lot. I prefer the Underboss a little bit more, and even though I bought both of them. How do I play Combat Medic? Actually, that's a good question, because that has come up in the past, and I've actually had an idea that actually caters to my style of play that I hope I can actually push when the Combat Medic update comes out. But basically, I play very reserved, because I know that if I die, everybody else gets screwed, so I usually let them run ahead and keep my medic gun out for the most part. I know that's not always the smartest thing to do, but that's how I prefer to play, is very reserved and in the background to make sure I can res everybody. What do I think of the three factions? Okay, well, in regards to the three factions, you guys are going to probably end up hating me, or at least some of you might. It's almost exactly the same as I thought of them in Planetside 1, and it's not because I have a skewed view of things, but I really dislike the NC the most, the new conglomerate. Now, that stems from a lot of things. That might also come from the fact that my server has a super overpopulation of NC that can basically do anything they want whenever they want. And it was fine for a while, right up until the point where the OMFG patches hit, and all of a sudden a huge amount of NC came back to the game after that, and it's been ridiculous ever since. It's not unusual to see the NC have like 42% world population on my server, that's Connery, while the other two are in the 20s. It's just beyond ridiculous, and I see this almost every day. But I also hated their jackhammer in Planetside 1. It was the bane of my existence back then, and I probably like them the least. I was really dedicated to playing TR when this one was announced, Planetside 2 was announced, and I met some people actually over the years, and one in particular actually is the leader of my outfit, really wanted to play the Vanu Sovereignty, and I gave it a shot. And I swear, within a week, I felt right at home. It wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. I play TR and NC both, but that's why I play Vanu mostly for this particular game. Do you like the combat medic? Yeah, I love it. That's actually a really fun role to play. What adds do you use for combat medic weapons? Add-ons. Basically, I just go with laser sight a lot of times on, I guess it would be the HV-45 or TAR in particular. Sometimes it's really useful to use a suppressor so that you can stay alive a little bit more in case you do have to make the occasional kill. That's not that I don't kill as a medic, it's just that I try to prefer to play to the role where I stay in the back. I think I use the underboss though, which doesn't have a suppressor option. I'll have to check that actually. But I use the advanced shield because the advanced shield capacitor lets me stay topped off all the time, basically. Within just a few seconds of me getting hit, I can actually heal myself and get my shield back to full. So I prefer that for that class probably more than any other class. I also use it for heavies a lot too. It depends on what I'm looking for. A lot of times I go for flak or nanoweave. That's what I use mostly for combat medic. And in regards to the grenades, I've been using the res grenades mostly lately. In the past, I had used the healing grenades a lot more often, but lately I've been using the res grenades. So I think I've kind of overstated that particular set of answer right there. All right, next question. Did I mention smokestacks? No, you didn't. Not enough, anyway. You need to say smokestacks every now and then. We do in our outfit, and that's basically how that started, is that, in case anyone was curious on the origin of that whole thing, basically we were making fun of the rather famous Geico commercial with the camel talking about hump day. Hump day! And we were doing that as a group of guys just being silly. And we were talking about the exhaust pipes actually as an option for the Sunder, and somehow we ended up doing that all of a sudden. Smokestacks! Smokestacks! And ever since then, basically one thing led to another. I got to basically talk to the guy that's the voice of the Honest Trailers, John, and I got him involved with it. And yeah, he still actually is on my Skype list and so on, but he's a really nice guy, great guy. But yeah, it just turned into this whole kind of like, infomercial style of video, and I've gotten a lot of comments on that video, and I'm glad that you guys like that, and I'd like to make more stuff like that in the future. It's just funny.
I am Optimus Prime. Subscribe to Energyone because, like me, This channel is more than meets the eye.